Yeah, good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. H.S. Nanda, principal at Bangalore Technological Institute. It's given an opportunity to give online classes of Module 5 in the subject Analysis of Determinate Structures under VTUE Sikshana program. I thank the team of eSikshana VTU and also reviewer of civil engineering subject, Dr. Ramakrishna Gowda, professor and HOD at MIT, Mysore. The topic of Module 5 is arches and cable structures. That I will be presenting. Coming to my brief profile, I am Dr. H.S. Nanda. My mobile number 9845655234, and this is my mail ID. For any clarification or doubts from the students, they can contact me. My academic qualification: I completed my PhD in the year 2007, M.Tech in 1993, B.E. in Civil Engineering in 1986. Now I worked in 3-4 institutions. Started my career at Malnad College of Engineering, and I worked for 2 years. Then in KVG College of Engineering, a different cadre for 13 plus years. Then I joined Nagarjuna College of Engineering and worked as assistant professor, professor and principal for totally 10 years. Since from 2011, I am working as principal at Bangalore Technological Institute, Bangalore. And coming to my achievements, I have published about 50 papers, technical papers, and attended about 60 seminar conference workshops and organized about 70 seminar conference workshops, and I guided more than 40 UG projects, about 10 PG projects, and guided 3 PhD. And coming to membership, I am a life member of Indian Geotechnical Society, life member of IST and Institution of Engineers. Now I will be taking these arches first. Now, if you take our conventional beams, for larger spans, these horizontal beams will become uneconomical because if you take like this, subjected to a loading, an ideal case, the bending moment diagram will be a parabola. Maximum bending moment will be at the center, and shear force diagram will come like this roughly. Here maximum shear force will be near the support, maximum bending moment will be in the mid span. The cross section of the beam to be provided near the support is to resist this maximum shear force or shear stress, whereas the shear stress or shear force will be becoming zero near the mid span. We are designing a cross section ear to resist the maximum shear stress, but when it comes to middle, the cross section required will be very, very less. Similarly, if you are designing for a bending, maximum bending moment will be at the middle span, and we will be designing the cross section for the maximum bending moment, whereas the bending moment will be zero near the support. In other words, the cross section required will be very, very less to resist the bending moment near the support. But we are providing the cross section to resist the maximum bending moment. In other words, unnecessarily we are providing the more area or more material at some points where it is not required also. Therefore, this will become uneconomical. And if the span is, or the length of the beam is larger, the cross section of the beam also will be thicker or bigger, and self weight also constitutes heavy loading on the beam. Therefore, it will be uneconomical. Now, to overcome this, if we provide arches across the structures, it will be more economical. That is like this. Even in ancient days, for the historical building also, over the opening, instead of providing a thick stone slab, they were using arch construction. And nowadays, for larger span, especially across the obstructions, these arches will be used. Arches are curved beams. Usually, arches will be supported on abutment, or they are called springes, between the two abutments, or if the obstruction is larger, in between piers also can be provided, and it constitute number of arches. If you take a single arch, the distance between the two supports, it will be called as span. And the highest point of the arch is called crown. The distance between the supported point to the highest point, that is crown, is called rise in the arch. These are the parts of the arch. Coming to the forces acting on the arch section, at any cross section if you take, this arch will be subjected to a normal thrust which acts along the axis of the arch, and a shear which acts along the radial line, and it is also called radial shear, and a moment, it is called the bending moment. Because most of the load will be transferred through this normal thrust along the axis of the arch, the radial shear and the moment will be less as compared to the horizontal structure. Now, if you take arches, there are different types of arches that depends upon the material of the arch, or it may be depending upon the shape of the arch, or it depends upon the support points. Based on the material, it is as usual. Whichever the material we will use, that will be the type of the arch. Depending upon the type of the supports, the arches will be 3-inched arches. In 3-inched arches, usually 2 hinges will be supported at the abutment or pier lan, and one will be at the crown, and it will be called 3-inched arch. And if hinges are provided only at the support points, abutment or springing levels, they are called 2-inched arches. Then it's one more type of arch. It is called fixed arch, wherein both the ends are fixed to the support points. Now, 3-inched arches are statically determinate. 2-inched and fixed arches are statically indeterminate. As per the syllabus, we deal only 3-inched arches. How this? Three-inched arch is statically determinate. As we know, statically determinate structures are the structures just by making use of equilibrium conditions. If it is possible to determine all the unknowns, it is called statically determinate structures. You take 3-inch arches. This is the 2 inches, and this is 1 more inch at the crown. Now we will be having support reactions. And totally, there will be 4 unknowns. This is HA, H, this is VA, and this is VB, and this is HB. There are 4 unknowns. If 4 equations are available, then it will become statically determinate. Now, we have an equilibrium condition, sigma fx is equal to 0. One equilibrium condition, sigma fy is equal to 0. Another equilibrium condition, sigma ma r about b is equal to 0 is one more equilibrium condition. Now we have the inch, 3rd inch at the crown C. Now by applying one more equilibrium condition, sigma mc is equal to 0, we can develop one more equation. Therefore, totally there are 4 equations and there are 4 unknowns. Therefore, this 3-inched arch can be analyzed just by making use of equilibrium conditions. Therefore, 3-inched arch is a statically determinate structure. In this subject, we deal only 3-inched arches. Now, 3-inched arches, depending upon the shape, they may be circular or they may be parabolic. We deal both circular three-edged arches and parabolic three-edged arches. Coming to the analysis of three-edged circular arch. Now this is the arch. This one of a circular arch. Here these are the two supports, and this is C, another hinge at the crown. Now if L by 2 and L by 2 are the half spans of this circular arch and small h is the rise of the arch, if this is h, we know this full length is 2r, nothing but diameter of the circle. Now this will be 2r minus h. Now by the property of the circle, L by 2 by L by 2, that is chord length, half of the chord length, will be equal to the product of these two heights, h and this 2r minus h. From this, if you simplify, we will get r is equal to L squared by 8h plus h by 2. Where L is the span, H is the rise, and R radius can be calculated. If you consider any point D, because that is most important, at any point what would be the, or what will be the, what are the forces acting, we have to analyze. Therefore, if you consider any point D, the coordinate of D, this can be calculated, this if x is the horizontal distance or abscissa of D with respect to origin A, x will be L by 2, this half length of the chord R span minus R sine theta. If it makes theta at the center, in this right angle triangle, this will be opposite side will be r sine theta. Therefore, x will be this full from A to this C, horizontal length L by 2 minus r sine theta. Then this y will be h, this h, minus r into 1 minus cos theta. This will be, this I want means here this one, this h full minus this I should deduct, this one. Now that will be r cos theta, this is r cos theta adjacent side in this right angle triangle geometry, r cos theta minus r from here, this r full radius minus h. We will get this y will be h minus r, if you take out r into 1 minus cos theta. That is the brief analysis or geometry that is required for the analysis of two hinged arches. Now, coming to three hinged parabolic arches, we know equation of the parabola with origin as A can be written as y is equal to 4hx by l squared into l minus x. That is the equation of the parabola we should remember, or we know that. Area, h is the rise of the arch, l is the span, the horizontal distance between A and B, and x is the abscissa for the point D, horizontal coordinate, and this vertical coordinate y can be written as this. Now, this is the simplest way the parabola equation that we should know that is required in the analysis. If the springings or supports are at same level, this is fine. If the supports are at different levels, then L1, we have to remember this equation, L, the horizontal distance between the two supports A and B is the total span, nothing but, into H1 is the height of the crown above the left abutment or supports, and H2 is the height of the crown above the right support. Right support. This is H2. Therefore, L1 and L2 can be calculated using these two equations. We have to remember equation of the parabola, and if the supports are at different level, the distance, horizontal distance between the left support and the crown hinge, and right support and the crown hinge, that is L1 and L2, this formula we have to remember. Now, coming to the analysis of three hinged arches, as I told already, three hinged arch is a statically determinate structure, because if you take the two supports A and B, there will be two reactions, horizontal HA at A, vertical reaction VA at A, and HB and VB are horizontal and vertical reaction at B. For any loading, to solve these four equations, we should know four equilibrium conditions or four equations. The four equations we have: sigma fx is equal to 0, that is algebraic sum of all the horizontal forces acting on the arch will be equal to 0, and sigma fy is equal to 0, algebraic sum of all the forces in vertical direction will be equal to 0. Then, by taking the equilibrium condition of moment, by taking moment center as A or B, that is sigma MA or sigma MB is equal to 0, will be another condition. Then we have this crown hinge C, that is sigma MC is equal to 0, by considering equilibrium of the left side or equilibrium of the right side, by applying sigma MC is equal to 0, it is possible to express one more equation. Therefore, from these four equations, we can solve this four unknowns, HEA, VA, HB, and VB. Now, the same convention used for these equilibrium conditions as we dealt in our elements of civil engineering or in strength of materials. Same sign convention you can use. In my discussion, while applying sigma fx is equal to 0, I use upward forces for this. For this, I use upward forces as positive and downward forces as negative. Then coming to, this is for sigma fy. Then for sigma fx, I use rightward force component as positive and leftward force component as negative. Then coming to these two conditions, algebraic sum of the moments, the sign convention used is clockwise moment. The forces which are trying to create clockwise moment like this, let us take positive, and the forces which are causing anti-clockwise moments will be taken as negative. That is the sign convention I use in my discussion. Nothing wrong if you change also here. That is for sigma fy, you can use upward as negative also, but if you use upward forces negative, downward force should be taken as positive. Similarly here also, similarly in this sigma mc condition also, any sign convention we can use. That is finding the support reactions, the preliminary step in the analysis of three hinged arches. It may be circular arch or it may be parabolic arch. Now, most importantly, for the design purpose, we need the forces acting at any point or at any section along the arch. If you take any point D, any point in the arch, the forces acting are the normal thrust, as I told already. Most of the load acting on the arch will be transferred along the axis of the arch, and it is called normal thrust. That is why bending will reduce. That is normal thrust along the axis of the arch. Then a force which acts across the cross section of the arch is called radial shear, and usually it will be denoted by F. This is by N. These are the two forces mainly. Moment also will be there, I'll come to that later. Mainly I am concentrating here on normal thrust and radial shear, N and F. N is along the axis of the arch, F is across the arch cross section. That is the value of radial shear and normal thrust at any section D here can be calculated by considering equilibrium of the portion DA. This is A, this is D. The vertical and horizontal forces on the section D can be calculated. Here, V and H. That is, for the equilibrium of the portion between A and D, the vertical force here, for the equilibrium of this, vertical force will be, suppose if a load is acting W1, for equilibrium of the vertical forces, V will be equal to VA minus W1. That is, by applying sigma Fy also, sigma Fy is equal to 0 for this portion, we can get V is equal to VA minus W1. And again, for the horizontal equilibrium, H or horizontal force acting at D, H can be calculated as no other horizontal forces on the arch, therefore H will be equal to H. HA we know from equilibrium condition of the whole arch. Now to find the support reaction, we are considering equilibrium of the whole arch. Remember, equilibrium of the whole arch. Now I have considered equilibrium of the portion A to D. As the whole arch is in equilibrium, any portion in the arch should also be in equilibrium. That is, by writing the free body diagram of the portion AD, thinking that W1 is acting between the points A and D, this V will be VA minus W1 and H is equal to HA. Now resolving, we can find the normal thrust and radial shear. Normal thrust N will be V sin theta. This V, if you resolve along N, it will be V sin theta and H cos theta. That means both will be acting in the same direction. Therefore, normal thrust N will be V sin theta plus H cos theta. And radial shear F can be calculated by resolving the component of, resolving V and H along F, that is across the cross section or along the radial line. That is why it is called radial shear. That is, V cos theta, if this is theta, this angle also will become theta. Therefore, it is towards the angle V cos theta acting in the direction of F. And H, it will try to resist or counteract V cos theta, that is H sin theta. That is why radial shear will be less. Whereas normal thrust will be the sum of H cos theta and V sin theta. That is why most of the force will be transferred through the axial compression. That is why flexure will be less, cross section required will be less, and hence it will be economical because material required will be less. Self weight of the arch also will reduce. You can see in bridges, most of the bridges, they were with arches. Okay, come to here. That is, to find normal thrust and radial shear at any section or at any point in the arch. External loads also we should consider if external loads are acting between the points that you are dealing. That is about normal thrust and radial shear. Now coming to the bending moment. Now at any section D again, with coordinate x and y, the bending moment will be sum of the moment in an equivalent beam minus the ordinate time horizontal thrust. That is, bending moment at any point or at any section will be beam moment minus h into y. That is the moment due to the horizontal reaction at A. Now, hence, bending moment for equivalent beam may be drawn to subtract h into y moment. We note that moment of the central edge will be zero because it is an inch. Here also bending moment will be zero. Here also bending moment will be zero. Here also bending moment will be zero. Therefore, first, parabola will be drawn with ordinate is equal to h into y at any section, or it is h into h at the crown point, and that will be the, that is called hy diagram. And beam moment diagram will be drawn due to the loads asked by considering our conventional beams due to external load. That means what we do in conventional beams, horizontal beam, and we will be drawing the bending moment due to external loads. But here, this beam moment will become less because horizontal beam, just understand the concept carefully, horizontal reaction here will try to reduce the moment due to the external loading. The external loadings will be creating a bending moment like this, but because of the horizontal reaction, that will be contracted because it will be pressing the arch. That is why the bending moment will be less. Only this is the net bending moment diagram. If it is not there, arch effect is not there, no bending moment due to horizontal force, that means bending moment diagram will become bigger. Now this will be contracted to the bending moment. Therefore, this h and y central ordinate will be negative bending moment, that will be contracted by positive bending moment. Therefore, left with only this bending moment diagram. This may be again another parabola if this portion is subjected to UDL. It is a beam moment. I have written here as an example with 2 points, thinking that there will be 2 point loads acting. Beam moment. Only thing is, in horizontal conventional beams, we were taking neutral axis or beam axis, or zero axis as horizontal. But now we will take beam axis as along the arch itself. That is h and y diagram it is called. And with that, this will be drawn. And beam moment diagram, it is merged. That will be the net bending moment diagram. We will see that in numerical problems. That is the analysis of 3-inched arches. Very, very simple. Okay. Mainly, whatever may be the loading, we have to consider, first step is to find the reactions. In any analysis, it will be finding the reactions just by applying equilibrium condition as we discussed. Then, if they ask you to calculate normal thrust or radial shear at any section, that will be the another part of the question usually. They will ask you to find the normal thrust radial shear at any point. It may be left side of the arch or it may be right side of the arch. Support points are at the same level or they may be at different level. Arch shape may be parabolic or it may be circular. We will see all those things in numerical problem. Totally, here, first step is finding the support reaction by applying equilibrium conditions. The second one is to find the normal thrust and radial shear at any point, we have to consider the equilibrium or free body diagram of that portion, A to any point D. If that point D is after C to the right side of the arch, some area, then it is this free body diagram from year to year it will be considered. In that case, load up to this point, external load acting should be considered. And free body diagram, if it is written, V is the vertical force unbalance for free body diagram and H is the horizontal reaction as usual. Here, like this. V and H can be calculated by applying equilibrium condition, by considering equilibrium of that portion only. That is this. Not necessary to remember these equations, just by from first principle by applying equilibrium condition depending upon the loading. There may not be W1 sometimes, or there may be UDL here. In that case, this formula will change. From first principle, we will find the vertical force and horizontal force for the free body diagram or for the equilibrium of this portion. Once if you find V and H, it is just by resolving, we can find normal thrust at that point and radial shear. That is V sin theta plus H cos theta. Both are acting in the direction of N, therefore they are somewhere sum. Whereas radial shear, they will be acting in different directions. Therefore, F radial shear will be V cos theta minus H sin theta. Okay. Then coming to the bending moment diagram, as we discussed, the net bending moment diagram will be B moment minus the moment due to horizontal reaction. Horizontal reaction moment will be always hugging, and at any point it will be H into this vertical distance Y. At the crown only it is H into H. Therefore, if you draw this moment diagram due to horizontal reactions, it will be a parabola or depending upon the shape, and B moment will be superimposed on this, we will get the net diagram, that is the bending moment diagram. That is whether it is parabolic arch or it may be circular arch. But these equations for the geometry we require, that is in parabolic arch, and this equation in circular arch. We will discuss that in the next R class. Okay, thank you. We will discuss numerical problem in the next class.
Thank you.